Okay, so Alaric has given already the different classification systems which can use. But for the practicing orthopedic surgeon, I think we have to remember only two things, that whenever you get a fracture of the upper end of the tibia, you can just broadly divide them into whether the injury is involving the physis or it is a metaphyseal fracture. These are the two very important, I mean, type you can remember in your mind, or you can classify, or you can remember, because the management is definitely matters when, if the fracture is involving the physis or the, it is a metaphyseal fracture. If the injury is involving the physis, you have to do some kind of fixation. We know all that they are rare and they are associated with a kind of a high sports trauma. But here the important point is that you will have to fix by one or the other way. Particularly the tibial tuberosity fractures, naturally these are the fractures you can't manage just by conservative treatment. You need to fix it. And if the injuries of the proximal tibial physis is there, they will require some kind of fixation. Either you can use the K wires or you can use the screws. Like, so most of the times they require some or the other kind of fixation, or the surgery is required. Okay, that is there. So this is regarding the injuries which are involving the physis. Okay, now the second is metaphyseal injuries. They are definitely most stable, and treatment is very straightforward in most of the cases, where you just simply need to immobilize them in a long leg cast. This example is a 4-year male child, the simple fracture. You just give a standard long leg cast and this, it unites very nicely. Okay. Another case where a 1-year male child, but your cast, as Dr. Sheetal has demonstrated the good technique for the, and even the Premal has demonstrated how to apply the spike also. So your casting technique should be good, that you should not create more trouble. Even this simple looking type of fracture, this was this child was managing. See, there is a varus, you know, when the plaster was removed, so there is a varus. So I think your casting technique has to be good so that you are not creating trouble. Right, we know that it is going to remodel, but the idea from this case is that you can apply, still apply the good quality of cast. Does that mean that every metaphyseal fracture you can manage conservatively? The answer is no. This is an 8-year female child. She had accident trauma, presented to one of my colleague, and this was the reduction. Is this acceptable? This is a, he just tried to reduce it and just put the plaster. Is this reduction acceptable? How many feel? Okay, so patient had some kind of pain, you know, so he just thought of the compartment syndrome. As we have heard Alaric, now these injuries usually are associated with a lot of, I mean, compartment syndrome and the popliteal artery injury or the posterior tibial, right? So you should be aware of. So he just took off the plaster and just given the slab, and the slab was kept for 1 month, and this is at 6 weeks the child presented to me. In the AP view, does it look okay? But if you see the lateral, this is there. Okay, is this acceptable? No, because the spike, which is, it is going to cause a lot of trouble to the posterior tibial vessel. And when she presented to me, she has absolutely excruciating pain. There is paresthesia. So I just decided to proceed. So naturally, this is going to require a fixation, open reduction, and you have to align it. So we did just opened it, stabilized it, and this is a subsequent follow up. She had a good function and good union, right? So the message is, reduction is definitely the key, as we think of in all other kind of injuries. Don't hesitate if you feel that your fracture is not stable. Just stabilize with simple smooth pins or the wire, or even a single screw you can use, and that can avoid the complication. So in summary, mostly these are the stable injuries, particularly the metaphyseal injuries, and they can be managed very well with the conservative treatment. Operative treatment is usually required in irreducible fracture, open injuries, and the physial injuries. And you should be always be aware of loss of reduction, growth disturbances, because tibia also, upper tibia gives a good amount of growth for the limb length, and compartment syndrome and popliteal artery injury. Thank you all. Thank you so much.